is a assistant professor, head of the department, Department of Food Technology, Haldia Institute of Technology. It is an MBA accredited department. That is, we home science, we are accredited by NAC, but all the technology institutes, they are accredited by National Board of Accreditation, that is NBA. So, his main, I'm glad that he is the president AFST of India, Haldia chapter. That is, Haldia chapter is under his leadership, and lead auditor of FSSI and BRC. FSSI though.
Yes, FSSC.
Gaurav, is
it? Yeah, it is
FSSC. FSSC.
Yeah, FSSC.
Oh, okay, okay. I don't know it. I'm not sure. FSSC and BRC.
Right.
Okay. Now, Gaurav will talk about this a portion of your syllabus, and I think it will be helpful, as he is very much as he is specialized in this area. Okay, and please interact. Okay,
yeah,
students, can you hear me?
Yes
ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Yes, please interact.
Okay, for first, first I would like to share my screen. So students, you have to confirm whether you can see my screen or not. I'm just trying to present the screen. Is it coming, students? Anyone?
It's visible.
It's visible, right? All right. So firstly, I would like to take this opportunity and thank Dr. Poobali Dhar, Associate Professor of Department of Food and Nutrition, University of Calcutta. And I think, if I'm not wrong, Madam is also in charge of the Food and Nutrition Division Laboratory. I'm extremely honored and privileged to get this opportunity, what Madam has offered me, to interact with you all. And we are undergoing a very challenging time. So no need of my own introduction, as Madam has already told. And as you all know, that we all are undergoing a very challenging time. In fact, India, the vaccination process is going on with the largest population country, which is our country, with more than 1.4 billion population size. And there is a distortion in the supply chain of vaccination, what we get to hear every single day in the news. Not only the adult, but also in middle age group, it is not available so far from private and government bodies. So there are a lot of grievances also coming up. So this is the time where we need to be patient. We have to be, we have to understand the situation, and let's hope for the best. And it is advised to all of you that before I start the lecture, you all please maintain the social distancing and the kind of guideline given by the government of India and government of West Bengal, the health ministry. Wear the mask properly and practice the sanitation process. So thank you very much. So before I start with the product development, because I think I have 1 hour or some odd time, I would just like to give you the glimpse of the food processing sector, as you all are budding food technologist and food science specialist. In India, if you see that we are a country with 100% FDI in food processing, right? So these are the important glance I want to show you. Then we are a population of 1.3 to 1.4 billion. This figure was taken from a 2018 December report. So you can understand now population has also changed to 1.4 billion. Then we have implemented in our country one nation, one tax. Recently, you know that we have also implemented one nation, one food law. And if you go to fssai.gov.in, you will find that one nation, one law that is implemented by Food Safety and Standard Authority India, the regulator of our country. So FSSAI is the regulatory body of our country. They regulate and manage different food products and licensing and they ensure the food safety for our country. India is also the fastest growing economy in the world and globally ranked second in the food production, total food production, and ranked one in several agri commodities, agri and food commodities. So this is a glimpse of the GDP, that is the gross domestic product, pre-COVID. Don't consider the COVID situation, because from the last year April onward, when March onward, when the lockdown started, and we have experienced a tremendous fall in the economy and the consumption pattern also. And this is the situation where we have reached somewhere around 7.8 to 7.9% of GDP pre-COVID, right? So we were growing marginally good, although presently it is in the negative magnitude, the GDP of our country, and so as other few of the countries in the globe. So let us understand how this COVID has impacted different type of business. It is important before you conceive the idea of product, first you have to understand where our food business is standing. So if you categorize the exposure of COVID in terms of high exposure, low exposure, and moderate exposure, I've taken it from Moody's, which is one of the authenticated reference, you will find that food and food retail is in the low exposure. So that is the fortune we all food technologists and we all food science professionals we have, that this food sector have been impacted the least, right? Apart from few other sectors which are allied to food, like packaging sector, you can see, and also the pharmaceutical sectors, right? Whereas beverage sector was moderately impacted. And you must have seen the reports. If you see the reports of PepsiCo India Holding Private Limited or Coca-Cola, then you will find that their business have reduced to 40 to 50% from the last year annual sale volume. And one of the reasons behind that, we have become very skeptic about taking any food product, especially the soft drinks or carbonated drinks, right? And we have grown some consumption habit, which is more homely, more traditional in nature. These are all important inputs, my dear student, in order to understand that what kind of food you can innovate when you plan or ideate any food product. Moving on, if you see the economic impact more in the statistical way, you will find that the GDP contribution during the COVID from food and agriculture sector have been significant with respect to some other sectors like oil and gas, metal and mining, and you can see also airlines and hotels, which are reduced by 70 to 75%, and food and agriculture sector has contributed about 15%, and which is very significant in this post-COVID era. So government has prioritized, and government has notified also in their sector specific sites. You can also go to Ministry of Food Processing Industry, the industry dedicated to manage the industrial operations in our country, known as Ministry of Food Processing Industry, known as MOFPI. So MOFPI has categorized and they have prioritized few sectors, and they have categorized as stage 1, stage 2, and stage 3. So in stage 1, you can see that food processing is one of the prioritized sector given by the government ministry, along with pharmaceutical, textile, and mineral sector. So this is the scheme that has been adopted by the ministry. The cabinet has approved this Sampada scheme in 2017-18, and it is related to, the scheme is related to agro-marine processing and development of agro-processing clusters. So this scheme actually has five divisions, if you see, starting with the scheme is emphasizing on providing quality food to consumers at cheaper price, then including schemes like Mega Food Park and cold chain projects. So West Bengal is also fortunate to get a food park. We have received a food park project back in 2008, 2009, and over the last one decade there have been significant development in different part of our state as well. Then reducing food wastage, so waste recycle and waste management have been given importance in order to develop value-added products and value-added foods, and reducing food wastage and increasing farmers' income. So this is one area where core area where government has taken some initiative that how to normalize farmers' income, how to improve farmers' income, and in the lower value chain of our society, how that can be contributed, right? Then encourage entrepreneurs to set up food processing units. So all the what I learned from madam, that all the final year students majorly they have joined. So you all are budding food entrepreneurs. You have studied the food science. You understand the technology. So I encourage all of you to take it as your startup. If you have some idea, you come up apart from joining industry and understanding food business, you can also have an option to go for entrepreneurship, and you can have your own business. Then allocation have been done 6,000 crore for the period of 2016 to 20, and now that has further been extended due to this COVID situation. So what are the learning objectives? So I am expecting my expectation with this lecture is you would be able to understand how companies find and develop new product ideas, how they list and define the steps in the new product development process, and the major considerations in managing the process and the product, not only the process but also the product. Then describe the stages of the product life cycle. So as you know that we from academia we have some specific goal in imparting any knowledge to you, and these are the goal actually. This is the outcome, that is the course outcome. We call it course outcome or CO. So there are 5 to 6 CO what I have written actually, what you should understand, and eventually if you become a successful product developer, definitely doing some benchwork in your laboratory, then you would be able to relate all these 6 parameters. So let us hear what are the 6 parameters relate to product development. First is ability to apply knowledge of science, mathematics, engineering fundamentals, including research-based knowledge for formulation of new products, new food products, and to modify existing food products to meet the societal and cultural needs. So this is something very important because you have to understand the need of the customer based on social and cultural differences, what we have in our country. Then ability to identify the problems during product formulation, scale-up, storage, or shelf life, and to develop solutions for those practical food technology or food science-based problems. Then next is the ability to apply basic engineering techniques in product development to meet societal needs within realistic constraints such as economic, environmental, ethical, cultural, legal, health and safety, feasibility and sustainability. So every single point is very important when you develop any product. It is not only the safety of the food, which is the primary thing, food safety. Apart from that, also the health-related issues relate to that food, the legal constraints, the cultural aspect, the ethical aspect, the environmental aspect. The environmental aspect comes with the packaging material you are using, or maybe some pesticide if it is there at all in the food. Then the economic aspect, feasibility, and sustainability. So sustainability is the key, because if you cannot sustain your product in the market for long term, then the product would be recalled or withdrawn, or eventually the product will not do good in the market and some competitors will come and grab the market, right? Ability to review research literature, analyze and interpret data using modern computational tools, and synthesis of the information to provide valid conclusions. So data analytics is very important. in order to understand the market. So it is not only the development part, which I was discussing with Pobali ma'am, that it is not only the development of the product, but also how this product will do good in the market, what is the consumer need, what consumer want, and based on consumer requirement, you are actually trying to develop some product. So that is a consumer driven product. So for understanding the consumer demand, you have to have good data analysis, and you have to use some statistical tool as well in order to understand the market. Then ability to understand engineering and management principles and apply those in food product development, taking into consideration the aspect of financial management. So costing is somehow also very important. It is not only developing a product by adding many ingredients and formulating it, but the prototype, if the prototype is very costly, then that also would not have any logical conclusion in the market, because the cost is very important. As long as you are running this product in our Indian context, right? Then ability to recognize the need and function effectively as an individual, as a team member, which is very important, that you have to become a team member or a leader to manage projects in multidisciplinary settings in the broader context of technological changes and to develop budding entrepreneurs. So technological changes is the key. You understand that post-COVID, whole the scenario, whole the business has changed, and companies are finding new avenues to manage their existing product, and they are coming up with new product based on new consumer demand. Now, these are the outline of the discussions of my first presentation, that is the product development strategy, new product development process, managing new product development, and product lifecycle strategies, right? So, an organization can obtain a new product through these two tools. First is acquisition. Second one is new product development. Anyone from the student, if you confirm that whether my voice is audible or not.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Thank you. So I don't want it to be a monologue. If you have any question, please stop me and ask question. I would be happy to answer. If at all I can answer, or you can discuss, right? So an organization can obtain new product through acquisitions or by developing a new product. So what you understand by acquisitions? Anyone from you understand what is acquisition? I would be more than happy to hear you. Anyone, what you understand by acquisitions, or any of the example if you can give, that in the food business, any acquisition or merging you have heard? Anyone? Any language you can use. Bengali, Hindi, English. I'm comfortable with these three.
So is it related to importing?
Not importing. Importing is a very different thing. That means you are importing some ingredient, like, as you know, that post-COVID, there are many materials, ingredient, including the packaging material, which are actually imported from China. And there are some ban from the ministry, and then it has somehow distorted the supply chain of food industries, and it has impacted the product development as well. But that is something I'll discuss maybe in a different forum, not import. Acquisition means taking the whole brand, right? So let me give you some example. So acquisition refers to the buying of a whole company, a patent or a license to produce someone else's product. So maybe you are the brand name. Say for an example, you are the brand name Complan, which is manufactured by Heinz Global, and our country subsidiary Heinz India. From over the years, from your childhood, you used to take this brand Complan, and suddenly you heard that Complan, this brand, is taken by a new company, which is a pharmaceutical company by basis is Zydus. Now Zydus has taken the whole brand Complan. So now at present, Zydus manufactures Complan. So Heinz is no more taking care of this Complan brand, and they have actually sold the brand to Zydus. So that is the brand acquisition concept, right? Like for an example, I can tell you non-food segment, Imami has taken the Frank Rose. Frank Rose is the medical shop, you must know. And Frank Rose is managed by Emami, right? So, which is a part of product development, but a new product development refers to original products, product improvement or product modification. Existing product modification can also be regarded as new product development, and new brands developed from the firm's own research and development. So new product development and acquisition has differences. I think you understood the concept now, that new product development includes original product research, product improvement or product modification, and new brand development from the firm's own research. So some acquisition, I'll tell you some example of acquisition. As I was mentioning that post-COVID in 2020, seven largest acquisition I have cited for you. These are M&A is nothing but merging and acquisition deals in food and beverage industry globally. So these are the global data, and in the follow-up slide, I have the data related to our country. So PepsiCo buys energy drink Rockstar. I think Rockstar is one of the well-known energy drink like Urza, like you know Red Bull. So Rockstar is taken by PepsiCo now, and then Kraft Heinz sales natural cheese business to Lactalis, another company. Then Nestle buys peanut allergy treatment maker. Then Mars buys Kind North America. Nestle buys Freshly. Freshly is one of the valuing meal delivery firm. Then McCormick buys hot sauce maker company. And these are larger acquisitions. You can see the deal of acquisitions with $3.85 billion. $2.6 billion. So you understand that the kind of business the this kind of company was doing, and then merging took over. Then Diageo, another alcoholic beverage industry of UK, primarily in Europe, to pay up to $610 million to buy Ryan Reynolds backed aviation gin, right? It's a fermented beverage. These are acquisitions of Indian brands, recent acquisitions I've cited. One I've already given the example, that is Zydus has taken the Heinz Indian business, including Complan brand, with a huge margin, you can see. Then ITC completes the acquisition of spice maker Sunrise. So Sunrise, basically the Sunrise brand is managed in Bengal only, and you must have seen Sunrise advertisement in broadcasting, you know, in televisions. And ITC has taken over recently the Sunrise brand. Then Food Panda, another food supplier, they tied up with Indian Railway Catering and Tourism Corporation for delivery of food to the passengers. And Adani Wilmar, which is another giant oil manufacturer in our country, and now they are no more into oil. They have explored beyond oil to many of the essentials and other products, cereal based products, pulses and other things. So Adani Wilmar has taken over the Ruchi brand, which is another oil brand, and they have created a joint venture, right? So what is the definition of new product development? So different authors, if you see, go to the literature, you will find that different authors have reported new product development differently. I have taken two major definition, and I have not cited here, but if you require the reference, I'll share it to madam, so that it will be helpful for you for understanding. So new product development is the process of bringing a new product to the marketplace. Innovative businesses thrive by understanding what their market wants. So that is what exactly I was telling, that what their market wants, making smart product innovations and developing new products that meet and exceed their customers' expectations. So this is the most important one, that a product, whatever you are making, that should satisfy or comply to the requirement of the customers. Making sure that you are taking care of the regulatory quality aspect, the food safety aspect, the legal aspect, the environmental aspect, all those different technical aspects you are taking care of, and you are meeting the customer expectations. Now, another definition is very similar to this definition, which is new product development is a series of steps that includes the conceptualizations, design, development and marketing of newly created or newly rebranded goods or services. The objective of product development is to cultivate, maintain, and increase a company's market share. So this is the ultimate goal of any company. That is the business goal, that they have to increase their market share by satisfying the consumer demand, right? So I think it is understandable, right? So if you say yes, then I'll proceed.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. So what are the core attributes of a product? Core attributes of any product. Forget about food product. Any product, whatever you take, the core attribute of product. So core attribute is nothing but the confidence related to a product. The physical attribute, because we, whenever we go to any shop, we first see how the product looks. That is the most important thing. And that is why nowadays, over the last two decades, lot of emphasis, lot of focus have been given to packaging innovations. You can write it, right? Because lot of product with the same type of formulations, but new type of packaging, they have been launched in the market and they have done really good in the market, because the market, whenever you go to any market shop, you first look at the product, how it is displayed, how it looks apparently, and how the packaging looks like. So all those things are very important, whether the product is transparent or not. So those things are very important. So physical attribute is important. Then special features and guarantees, if at all they are not applicable to food products, because as you know that food product comes with a shelf life. And today I have a discussions, if time permits, that I'll give a small glimpse of shelf life based on different type of products. So shelf life also is very confusing sometimes, because there are products coming up with extended dates, with use by dates. So I'll tell all those things. Then brand and brand image is very important for any of the company. Brand comes first. And then intangible or psychological benefits of a product, and the product's safety aspect is very important. So these are the core aspect. So NPD may include what? Change in packaging. So change in packaging will also be regarded as new product development. Novel or unique products. So you are bringing a new formulation, new prototyping, new development and design of the product by your R&D team, or maybe driven by research, right? Then reformulation of the product for health. So reformulation have been done for many of the beverage sector and food processing sector. You must have seen, I'll also exemplify few, that reformulation have been done time by time. For an example, say slice or maza, as you know, or fruity, these are all non-carbonated, non-alcoholic beverage category. These are all thermally processed beverage, right? Now in this thermally processed beverage, if you go to industry, you will see that this concentrates, that is the pulp concentrates are added with the hot water and sugar, and then some other concentrates are added, which are nothing but the preservative. Preferentially, we use class 2 preservatives, and some formulations are done. So each and every formulation, if you see slice, if you taste slice, and if you taste maza, both does not taste same. So these are nothing but their own company innovations, by which one company product is different from the other company. Slice, maza, and fruity all are same category of product having different taste. So that is their own internal protocol and prototyping by PepsiCo, Coke, or Keventer, right? So reformulation is needed based on the advanced data you are finding, based on the research related to any preservative addition. For an example, if you see 10 years back, for this kind of thermally processed beverage, we used to add sodium benzoate. Right, and in the product declaration, if you see the product declaration, you will find that what kind of preservative is added. So in INS number, you will find INS 202, INS 234, all those things are written, because these are mandated declaration. You have to declare what preservative or what ingredient you are adding as per the compliance by the regulatory, that is FSSAI in our country, which is the law of the land, right? So this, if you are changing the any formulation, say for example, you are changing the concentration of the pulp, or you are changing the bricks, or you are changing any quality attribute or say you are changing the preservative, like what happened, like now nowadays potassium sorbate and lactate, these are added instead of sodium benzoate. So if you are changing it, that will also come under the reformulation or reconstitution in that category, right? And that will also be regarded as a new product. Then line extension. So if you are extending any line, so that is more related to the design aspect. So in any product, you will find that there is a design, like step by step, starting from, you know, receiving of raw material, then applying a lot of unit operations, like some blancher you are using, some cooker you are using, maybe some fryer you are using, say for example, fried product like kurkure, like Lay's, this type of products, it undergoes frying process. And then if you are at all using some other techniques, like some pasteurization, say for pasteurized products, you are using some pasteurizers. So these are nothing but the design aspect. So these are different unit operations, some thermal treatment you are using in order to reduce the hazard. But maybe you are designing the product in a way, you are extending the line of the product. So if you are changing the design, then also it will come under the new product development category. And also the change in portion size, right? So before you start developing any product, or before I go to the steps involved to a product development, so first understand why a product fails in the market. So what are the major reasons for new product failure? So these are the probable reasons of product failure, because if you see also that you go to any those who are staying in urban or suburban area, you must have visited the Metro Cash, the Spencers, the, you know, all, or you have ordered from Big Basket or some other grocers, some other retail stores, and you must have seen that there are many products which come in the market, but maybe when you go to the next month, you don't find that product in the shelf. So there are many products which are coming, but they are not retaining in the shelf, because those products are somehow rejected by the customers, right? So this can be a matter of all these parameters, including the overestimation of market size by the company, then poor design of the product. It includes also packaging based design, then incorrect positioning. Incorrect positioning, for an example, I'll tell you, like Danone has developed a product called Yakult, right? And Yakult is a probiotic based dairy beverage, where in the packet only it is given that what concentration of probiotics is added, the million of probiotic cell that is incorporated in that specific drink, that is already given, right? But initially when it was launched in different segment of our country, so it did not perform good in UP and Bihar. But that probiotic drink did really well in Kerala. So one of the, if you go to the root cause, then you will find that Kerala, the literacy rate is much higher. So they more understand the new product category, and they have larger acceptance to a new product. So these are also the parameter when a consumer is driven by a more acceptance pattern, or a consumer is driven by their self-belief. Self-belief means, or some values and beliefs, that my father used to take Britannia biscuit, so I'm also going to take Britannia biscuit, and I'm not going to take Best Farm. So this is the belief also, which plays very important role, pivotal role in acceptance of a product in our country, right? So incorrect positioning is also very important. Another example I can give, that real drink, which is more than 100 crore drink nowadays, real drink, which is launched by Dabur. And Dabur initially launched this real drink much before. They have launched it back in 2003, 2004, when it did not respond well. And then they have again launched it in 2011-12, when they have seen a significant increase in the sale volume. Like, I can exemplify another product, which is ITC product. ITC has also come, not only the biscuit and bakery category or confection category, but they have also come up in order to compete in the beverage band with Real. And they have developed a product which is called B Natural. But that B Natural product in segmented way, it did not perform well in our country. So far, the business is very bad with Be Natural, right? So companies, they keep on monitoring their product positioning, the timing, all those things are very important. You have to understand the pulse of the consumer, and then there are separate team to do that, which is a marketing team. But as a food science professional, you also have to understand the market, understanding you should have, right? Price too high may not work. That is another aspect. Then ineffective promotion. So promotion and marketing plays very important role for any product. Then management influence. Then high development cost if the whole product technology is very high. For an example, I'll just tell you that nowadays non-thermal products are also very much a buzzword in globally. If you see globally, non-thermal products are also in buzz, but you won't find much non-thermal product or sophisticated technology based product, say membrane separation based coconut water, which is coming. It is commercialized by a company from South India, and this coconut water is coming with a price of 40 rupees. So it is too high price, and also the technology is very high. At the same time, if you go to a product which is high pressure treated, which is nothing but a non-thermal operations. So nowadays, thermal operations are replaced by non-thermal operations like high pressure, like pulse light, pulse electric field, which may extend the shelf life of the product more than the thermal operations, and also it may restore the quality attributes in terms of sensorial quality, you know, in terms of the microbiological quality or chemical quality. But those technologies are so costly. Scale up of those technology in commercial scale is a very challenging factor. And when the product is coming in the market, it is coming with a very high price. So it is not getting a very good acceptance, right? Then competition is another factor. So if there are you are coming up with a product which has many variant by established brands, benchmarking brands, then it is difficult to sustain if you do not have your price policy. So these are the major stages in new product development. So basically these are 8 stages. In few of the books you may find 7 stages, but I can refer you a few authentic books where basically these are the 8 stages nowadays a business follows, starting with idea generation to idea screening to concept development and testing, then marketing strategy, then business analysis, then actual product development, then test marketing, and then finally commercializations. So to start with the idea generation, now if I tell you that every single individual, you are capable to think about a product. So if I tell you that it is your project now, that you have to develop, you have to give a concept, you have to develop a concept for a product. So think about any product, be it beverage, be it dairy, be it food, anything. So you think about a product which you can plan and you can market. Now what you will do? You will first ideate, or you will first think about that idea. So that is the idea generation phase. So you are generating some idea. Now the idea you have generated, whether that idea is a good idea, whether that idea can work in the market. So for that, then you have to, after you generate the idea, you have to screen the idea. So that is called idea screening process. And when you are doing the screening, then screening has to be done based on the benchmarked product, because the idea what you have developed, that definitely this type of product you have to find in what the kind of product you are thinking, whether that type of product is available in the market or not. If it is already available, then the benchmark companies which have already launched the product, what are the how those products are doing in the market. So based on that, when you are screening your idea, that is the idea screening or reviewing process. So you are reviewing your thought, right? Then you develop the concept. So I'm just going step by step. So idea generation, idea screening, then concept, testing and development, then marketing strategy, planning, then business analysis, then product development. So this business analysis you are projecting. This is nothing but a projected business analysis, right? That if you launch this product, what kind of business you can experience. Then product development, then test marketing, and then finally commercializations. So up to this, you are clear, everyone. So I just want to hear from you whether this part, I'm going individually one by one, because this is a very interesting and important stage I'm discussing now. So whether this part is clear, then I'll go one by one. I mean, একটা করে পয়েন্ট নিয়ে ডিসকাস করব। সো ফার্স্ট ইউ টেল হোয়েদার দিস থিংস আর ক্লিয়ার অর নট।
ইয়েস স্যার।
ক্লিয়ার স্যার।
ওকে।
ক্লিয়ার।
ওকে, গ্রেট। সো হোয়েন উই টক অ্যাবাউট আইডিয়া জেনারেশন, দ্যাট মিন্স a new idea, how it comes. The new idea generation is the systematic search for a new product idea. So that search can be internet-based search, social media-based search, that can be your own brain-driven some idea, right? That can be some observations you had regarding market, that can be your past experience, right? So it can come from anywhere. And sources of new product idea can be internal and external. So internal sources refer to company's own formal research. So if you think that you are working in a company, then company's own research. If you think as a student, then your own research. What I told, that maybe some secondary search like internet search, you can go for some, you visit a mall, you see what are the different type of product, and from that, the kind of idea you have, you try to relate with that product like this. So these are your internal resources you are using. Then external refers to sources outside the company, such as customers, competitors, distributors, suppliers, and outside design firms. Understand, each and every point I mentioned in external, starting from customer, competitor, distributor. So except competitor, customer, distributor, supplier, they are nothing but the stakeholder of your company. And if you think about in a different directions, that as a student, you can take some sample research. Maybe you are preparing a Google form and you are asking that what kind of product at present scenario, what kind of product would be accepted in the market, or what is the demand from an individual, and you explore it in the social media, maybe to 500 friends with a specific age group. It is also very important that with what age group you are taking that feedback, right? And it has become very popular now, because a lot of startups, they are coming up now, and they keep on sending this type of Google form nowadays, and they try to capture the response from different age group, be it 18 to 24, maybe, or maybe 25 to 40, maybe 40 to 55, like this different age group, you take the their response, and you will find with respect to the age group, the response of individual is changing, which is so interesting. And it is really very interesting. And when you actually do it, you will understand that consumption habit is also this consumption habit is monitored by so many parameters. Age group is one of the very important parameter, right? And individual habit also changes. And if you also refer to people who are staying in rural area, or people who are staying in urban area, who are staying in suburban area, their awareness level is also different. Not many knows many things. So based on their knowledge, based on their understanding, they will respond. And you have to capture the response, and you have to validate your idea. So this is also another way you can actually screen your idea. So screening refers to reviewing new product idea. That review can be done by self-driven mode. It can be done by external mode, as I have told, in reference to benchmark product. So if you at all plan to go for a butter lassi, then you have to see whether this butter lassi is already available in the market. Yes, it has launched by Mother Dairy. It has launched by Amul. It has launched by some other dairy firm. So you first see whether you go and see whether that product, in what are their ingredients, how, what is their price, how they are marketing the product, what are their target consumers, and then you more understand your idea. So what I'm trying to make you understand is your idea should not be a superficial idea. Any idea which comes to you, you first validate by yourself, and then you represent to maybe your teachers, maybe your somebody else, right? So product idea is an idea for a possible product that the company can see itself offering to market, and concept is a delayed version of the idea. So product concept and product idea both are not same. Understand, there is a difference between idea and concept. When idea comes immediately, right, whereas concept comes after validation of that idea, right? So it's a delayed version of the idea. And this concept also will have some meaningful consumer terms because you have validated your idea based on all those parameters, right? Then product image. Product image is the way consumers perceive an actual or potential product. So as a product developer, you have to also see how the product will look. Those are not also part of product development, core product development. But also, if you take the product cycle, then you have to think that how the product will look in the shelf. And these are also a part of the work which is done by marketing team as well as the R&D professionals. And this is the part of the concept development and testing. So concept testing, in one word, in one sentence, refers to new product concept with groups of target consumers. Then comes the marketing strategy development. So marketing strategy development refers to initial marketing strategy for introducing that product to the market. So somehow you have to understand that whatever the product you are developing, somehow you have to introduce that product. You have to find some channel to introduce the product in the market, right? Understanding the retailers, understanding the distributor, understanding the supply chain, and these are nothing but part of marketing, which also includes the advertisement and promotion part, right? Now, here I'll just give you part of informations where marketing strategy you can divide. So I've actually divided part one, part two, and part three for your better understanding. So part one describes the target market. So what is my target market? I am bringing a product only for diabetic patient. So if I'm bringing that product, a beverage, I'm planning for diabetic patient, which will act against diabetes type 2. Now, my target consumer is diabetic patient. So I will have my target potential consumer as diabetic, all the diabetic people in our country or in our state. So based on that, I have to take the review from the diabetic patient. You understand? So based on the target consumer, say for an example, Typhoo tea, you must have heard this name, Typhoo or Twinings tea, which are very costly tea and which is not a kind of CTC tea which is available in Bara Bazaar, right? This Typhoo, Twinings tea, these are all finest garden-based tea, green tea, which are available in malls and stores. And these are very costly tea. It comes in a 25 pouch box, comes with a price of 400, 500 rupees. So is that affordable by our lower strata of people or lower middle class people? No. So the company is not stopping their production. Why? Because they are not targeting the lower strata people. They have some target elite class consumer to buy their product. So every single company, they have a target consumer, right? Whether the product is for the whole mass or whether the product is very specific to a target group. So that you have to understand. And then positioning of the product based on sales, market share, and profit goals. Definitely, these are part and parcel of marketing strategy. You have to think about the profit margin as well. May not be initially when you launch the product, but over the time period, right? Then price, distribution, and budget. So you have to also budget your plan, and you have to think about the distribution pattern and the final price of the product. And this is also a very crucial thing what company does, because the actual cost of production for many of the beverages you consume every single day with 15 rupees or 20 rupees, the actual cost of production is maybe 1 rupee 30 paise or 1 rupee 50 paise. So where the rest of the cost goes? The rest of the cost goes to the retailer, distributor, the supply chain, the advertisement, you know, branding that product. So it includes the whole cost, right? Then part three is long-term sales, profit goals for long-term and marketing mix strategy. So just to give you a better insight, these are the conventional ways of marketing. Marketing people can guide me further, but these are the conventional marketing scheme what we have. 4 P's of marketing, which are globally acclaimed scheme of over the last 50 years, where 4 P's include product, price, place, and promotion. Right, 4 P's of marketing. But if you see now the company, the way the company is thinking to develop their product, these 4 P's of marketing are replaced by 4 A's of marketing. Now these 4 P's were product, price, place, and promotion. Have you noted this? 4 P's of marketing, everyone? Yeah, I'm just asking
yes,
for a
sir. Yes, yes sir.
Yeah, otherwise I'll just think that you are sleeping and I'm just speaking. So 4 P's of marketing are replaced by now.
ওরা WhatsApp group e likche.
Okay. So actually they are very smart. They are very smart and they take a screenshot. So when even I take classes, I see that students, they take screenshot and everything is accessible to them. But anyway, I'll just share this presentation to madam after the end of my lecture, so that you understand this better. So 4 P's of marketing, now it is replaced by 4 A's of marketing, which is very much prominent to our food business as well. And these 4 A's are what? Affordability, very important. Post-COVID, lot of changes in the economy. People don't have money. Right, they don't have money to purchase, so their purchasing power parity has reduced. Right, so they are looking for low cost product with equal quality, with equal value. Right, so affordability is the key. Now then, availability of the product. So maybe you have developed a product but you could not penetrate the market. You could not penetrate the rural market. You could not penetrate. Say, for an example, just I'm telling you a real-time situation. Now, today, it is going lockdown. And in lockdown, whenever 2 days, 3 days back, lockdown was announced, it is almost 90% lockdown going on based on the kind of restrictions what our state has imposed. Everybody started going to mall. Even I have visited the mall to purchase a certain grocery. Now, I found that it is extremely pathetic to see in this pandemic that all are, you know, jumbled up, be it wine shop, be it anywhere, be it you go to grocery shop, and everybody wants to take the product. And what will happen eventually, the product will not be available. And if you see the big basket, the Amazon, the other mobile application app, very unfortunately, you go beyond this district of Howrah, beyond this district of Calcutta, you go to a place like Bardhaman, you go to a place like Bankura, and you ask someone that, have you ever brought anything from Big Basket? They will say, why are you joking? So that means what? That means this Big Basket, Amazon or Spencer's are available in suburban and urban market, which is nothing but just 25-30% of the total consumption, I mean total population size. Now you think about the rest of the population size in our state, where those app applications are not working and they are finding it unavailable. Most of the products are unavailable. So it is really important that at present situation, it is the government initiative, but generally for company, their supply chain has to be very strong in order to penetrate their product to all the market. Maybe with different price tag for a rural market, for an urban market, they can have some segregation based on price, but availability of the product is really important, right? Otherwise, it will create some food insecurity issue. Then awareness related issue, it is also very important. So if you are not aware with the product, maybe you have not heard the term nutraceutical, you have not heard the term spiceuticals. So some product coming with a product category, nutraceutical, health supplements, spiceuticals, and you don't know all these names. So then how do you accept this product? So awareness level is very important. And it is an initiative which is taken under the Food Safety and Standard Authority India. They have taken Eat Right Movement. Under Eat Right Movement, they have introduced a lot of schemes. And you can also visit the website of FSSAI, where you can find different schemes. Those are launched by FSSAI. And nowadays, they are also virtually very active. Then acceptability, that is the most important one. So affordability, availability, awareness, these all are important. But acceptability is the key. End of the day, you have to accept the product wholeheartedly. Yes, I like this formulation. I like this beverage, or I like this type of product. That is very important. If the consumer in bulk phase, they are not accepting any product, then ultimately the product development, the marketing, the pricing, everything is a failure by the company. Right? And it is also a learning. It is not that many companies, I can exemplify, they have developed the product, they have failed in the market, and then again they came up with their experiences and they succeed. So it is the learning from the experience which does count in life. So new product development process, it will also include the business analysis, which involves a review of the sales, cost and profit projections. Why it is projection? Because you have not launched the product yet. It is the sixth step, right? The business analysis. So you are projecting the profit to find out whether they satisfy the company's objective or not, company's goal. End of the day, you have to satisfy with the product, the company's goal as well. So then it comes the product development. So after idea generation, idea screening, concept testing, marketing plan, then business strategy, then it comes the actual product development. What actually you are going to do under maybe your incubation cell, maybe your product development lab. Nowadays, difficult in a pandemic to allow you in the lab due to the restriction. But in the lab for long run, say saying that you are going to develop some product in the lab, which involves the creation and testing of one or more version of products by the R&D or engineering departments, which includes standardization. Very important term I'm using, standardization of the product. So whenever you are developing a product, you have to standardize the product. Now, if the product is a new product category, like some ingredient you are adding to a product for a health claim, understanding this COVID situation, maybe you are claiming that it has some immunity, it can improve the immunity of consumers, and you are imparting something which is not standardized, then you have to take a regulatory approval for the product before you launch to the market. So you have to really understand the standardization process, which involves a lot of technicality. So already there are standardization based on category of product. So based on category, the standardization procedure will change. And those standardization processes are already available in the regulatory site. You go to Codex, you go to other institutional guidelines, already the standardizations are already developed. But if you are developing some new product giving some new ingredient to develop any product that is called proprietary food, we call it proprietary food, then you have to get a new approval from the regulatory body before you launch it to the market, because they are going to give you the license for sale, right? And also not only the standardization, but also the validation of quality. Now, quality is a big term, and a separate class can be arranged to discuss the quality attributes of a product. Now, quality includes not only the physical quality, but also some physiochemical parameters, some microbiological aspect of the food, right? And also sensorial parameters. Sensorial parameter is extremely important for products, all for dairy products, for tea-based beverages. say for other type of beverages, and you know by that time that there are hedonic scale concept, duotriao taste, and this kind of taste we can discuss later on maybe. And you have to understand the sensory, because you have to also optimize the sensorial parameters apart from microbiological, chemical, and physical parameters. And why you need to ensure the quality? Because if you do not ensure the quality, then eventually you are going to add risk to the system, right? So if any of the parameter, maybe microbiological quality or physical quality or chemical quality or sensorial quality, does not go good, then the product quality becomes zero. So in quality terms, there is no concept. If you go to even ISO 9001:2015 document that is developed by International Organization for Standardization, right? Or if you see the definition of quality in ISO 22000 document that is newly developed in 2018 version, you will find that quality is nothing but regarded as a product of all these parameters. So any of the parameter is not complying to the requirement, to the standard, then the quality of the product is zero, and the acceptance would be according. So as a quality professional, you have to give it is very important for you to understand the value of quality of a food, right? And if you do not maintain the quality, what will happen? It will add risk to the process, and it will not ensure the food safety. So things are interrelated. This quality, food safety, and risk assessment, all are interrelated. And eventually what will happen? The hazard will come to a food, right? The hazard will come. Now this hazard is it is something which you don't want. And if the hazard comes, so there is no food in public which has zero hazard, right? So zero hazard food is not possible. So every food will have some hazard, but that hazard should be within the acceptable limit. That is the key. That is the understanding you have to have. So any product will have some microorganisms, but that microorganism level should not go beyond the acceptable limit of microorganism. What I'm trying to mean is zero hazard system is a hypothetical concept, but you have to make sure that you are complying to the acceptable limit of hazard based on all these quality parameters. I hope I could make you understand. And food safety aspect is very important. You have to take care of the HACCP plan, you know, hazard analysis and critical control point, then corrective action, preventive action, all those things are very important. And risk assessment is very important. You have to apply a root cause analysis if at all some risk is associated, and you have to eradicate the risk associated with it. And risk and hazard, although used sometime commonly, but risk is different from hazard. Let us understand this. So if you go to product standardization as per regulatory, then you go to FSSAI site. I've just taken a screenshot. You can also find. So for product standards, you can see health supplements, proprietary foods. Then you can see non-specified foods, organic foods, export quality foods. So for all these type of foods, different type of standards are already established. And you can see that product standards, you know, for this is for food additives and food product standards, then also for contaminants, toxin, and residues, and also for packaging and labeling, there are regulations. Although this 2011 regulation is newly amended now by FSSAI, and they have come up with a 2020 new regulations, which they have not uploaded, I guess, in the site. And then food safety and standard for nutraceutical products, say for foods for special dietary use, foods for special medical purpose, functional foods, and novel foods, all are categories, right? And then also for organic food, there are separate regulations, alcoholic beverage, fortification of food. So these are also very interesting term related to product development, fortification, enrichment. These are also very interesting term, and I would like to address those things maybe in the next class, because these are part and parcel of product development. Also, if you go to the health supplements, you can see that standards for health supplement and nutraceuticals are specified under food safety and standards. Health supplement, nutraceutical food for special dietary use, that I already have mentioned. Understand this, that genetically modified food is not acceptable till now in our in our country, except a few specific use. And also to note that we have graded only 8 allergen, not also by FSSAI, but as per ISO 22000, they have given 8 allergen, whereas if you go to any global standard, benchmark standard like food safety system certification or British Retail Consortium or safe quality food, these are different standards which are followed worldwide, which are recognized by Global Food Safety Initiative. It's a forum which benchmark the standards, and they have classified so far 20 type of allergen, right? Although in FSSAI so far no declaration came related to allergen, and now FSSAI has recently also classified allergen as a fourth type of hazard. Except physical, chemical and microbiological, allergen is also regarded as a fourth type of hazard, which is amended by codex as well. So proprietary food, it is also what I told, that if the regulation on proprietary food covers those food which are not standardized. So if you are adding any ingredient which is not standardized in food safety and standards, the act, you can see also, I can also share you the act, food safety and standards and regulation and food safety and standards. So if it is not standardized, then as per the regulation, any food product prepared using those ingredients which are either standardized or permitted to be used in standardized products does not require any separate approval. But if any ingredient you are adding which is not standardized, then, or it is not permitted to use as per the clausal requirement, then you have to take a separate approval, which I already told. Now comes the taste marketing. Now, taste marketing is the stage at which the product and marketing programs are introduced into more realistic marketing settings. So taste marketing means you are trying to taste based on the sample you have already prepared. You are going to the consumer before you actually launch, commercialize. You are trying to validate if everything goes current up to the sixth step, up to the product development. Now you go to, after developing the product with the real product sample, you go to the consumer. And going to the consumer also has different versions. I'll come to that. Taste marketing provides the marketer with experience in testing the product and entire marketing program before full introduction of the product in the market. So when a farm taste market, I think you are not getting bored, right? Because it's a monologue from me. You all are with your good attention, right? Anyone may respond?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right, thank you. So when farm taste market, then new product with large investment, when there is a need of taste market, because if a company is coming up with a new product category and with a large investment, right? So they are not very sure with the product, that how the product will do in the market. So before they actually launch it, so it's more like a premiere, you know, it's more like a premiere of a movie. So rather than a premiere, it's more like a trailer, not a premiere, it's more like a trailer. So from the trailer, if the trailer is very good and trailer is having a very good view in YouTube, maybe it is the trailer after the launch in one day, it is having a 10 million views. That means the movie can be hit, right? So it's more like this. So you have to first taste the market, and when you are not very sure, that is the uncertainty of launching the product. So uncertainty is part and parcel of any of the business giant. So this uncertainty about the product or marketing program, so you better taste the product in the market. And when the product may not be tasted and directly can be launched, if it is a simple line extension or maybe copy of a competitor product, so already the product, this kind of product is already existing and you are trying to develop a product which is just like a like slice, or it is just like a paperboard based mango based drink. So if you know that this type of product is already hit in the market in the specific that demography or that segment, then definitely you can go for the launch. Or if you know that the product does not involve much cost related issue, the cost of the product is very less, so you can actually plan for the launch. or management confidence. This is also another thing, that if the management is very confident about the product, they may not go for a test market and they can launch it. So I've just given some idea regarding the test market. That test market can also be categorized as standard test market, control test market, and simulated test market. Sometime you must have visited the malls and you must have seen some free samplings are going on, by different companies. Like one example I can give, Go is a company which came up with many of the dairy-based flavored beverage, dairy-based flavored beverage. And I still remember 3-4 years back, the product, the company products were not that established, and they were doing sampling for 2-3 months. Maybe the sampling they are doing because they wanted to take some review. And when you visit the mall, they will give you the free sample. If you like to take the free sample, then you have to fill up a data because there are some questionnaire, and you have to feed the data. And those things they do with the marketing team, right? So what is that standard test market? These are adapting small representative markets where the firm conducts a full marketing campaign and uses more store audits, consumer and distributor surveys, and other measures to improve the product performance, right? Then there are some challenges related to standard test market, related to it, because standard protocol takes time. It takes a lot of cost, and also competitor may monitor because you have not developed the product, and as it is taking a lot of time, maybe you are taking 6 month time. So some other competitor may take your concept and they can actually launch it within 3 months. And it has happened to many of the giant company. I'm not going to name the company, but it has happened. And based on that also, many movies are made, you can see. So in this aspect, it is also very important to protect your innovation. That is something what we don't discuss. Whatever the innovations you are doing up to now, you have to protect the innovation with intellectual property right, with patenting your products. And that is another interesting part. I would request madam also, if you can arrange any lecture with someone who can enlighten this intellectual property right or the patenting of the product. That is really important and interesting. Yes. Now again, going to control test markets, these are less expensive than standard test market and faster than standard, actually. And last one is, so these are not very important. These are very primary discussions I'm doing with this test market. So just you have to understand that before you launch the product, you have to test your product to take some valuable feedback from consumers. Simulated test market is the one which everybody does nowadays, which are events where the firm will create a shopping environment, maybe in a mela, maybe you know puppetry show like this for the village places. Sometime you must have seen some campaign going on, few people gathered in a place, not maybe in COVID situation, but pre-COVID you must have seen in front of the shopping mall, and creating an environment, and note how many consumers buy the new product, and based on the competitive products, and then provides measure of trial and the effectiveness of the promotions. And researchers can also interview consumers. So these are the advantages of simulated test markets, that less expensive than other test methods, faster, and restricts access by competitors, because it is not something where competitors are getting to know your formulations or other things. That is really important. And disadvantages, not considered as reliable because you are just taking a specific population. Say for an example, somebody stays at Goria and he is doing this kind of simulation marketing before the launch to a nearby place. Say for an example, you are doing it in Jadavpur. So in Jadavpur, you have taken 100 consumers, and that 100 consumers may not be from Jadavpur. Maybe few are running by consumers, few are stationed there. So those consumers, based on those consumers' feedback, you cannot actually map how the product will do in the market when it would be launched to different segment of our state. So that is actually the understanding that when you take any response, you must ensure that you have to take the feedback from different demography, from different part of the state. If you are launching it in the state, or if you are launching it in the outside the state, in the countrywide, pan India, then you have to make sure that different state, how they are responding. And that you have to do prior to launch. At least it will take another 1-2 months, 3 months maybe, based on the category of product, right? Then you go to commercialize the product, that is the launch. But also for launch, you have to understand when to launch, where to launch, and planned market rollout. These are the important understanding. All right. So successful new product development should be customer-centric, team-centric, and systematic. So I'm not going in detail of customer-centric approach or team-centric approach. Just mentioning that sequential new product development. So as you understood by now that new product development is not a one-stage goal. It is a sequential process which involves many of the part of the process. And when you accumulate all the process, then it's a product development, right? So basically, in academia, in research, what we get to see, systematic new product development, which is an innovative development approach that collects, reviews, evaluates, and manages new product ideas, right? And creates an innovation-oriented culture, which yields a larger number of new product ideas. So all of you, I believe that you have some uniqueness in you, which makes you different from others. And you also can develop, can generate an idea, validate the idea, and definitely in future, you can develop your own product idea and product development. So product life cycle is very important to understand. It is not only the product development, but also you have to introduce the product to the market, which is introduction of the product. And then growth of that product, how the product is doing good in the market, right? Then maturity of the products. Few of the products which are highly matured product. For an example, again, carbonated soft drinks, say Thumbs Up like product or Coke like product or PepsiCo like product, these are introduced in the market in 1990s. And if you see, for the last 30 years, the consumption is doing very good. Although after COVID, the sale volume has reduced, but over the 30 years, you know, doing the business is a big deal. Whereas they are doing nothing but giving sugar, right? Whereas if you go to other markets like European market, you will find that in European market, only Diet Coke, Diet Pepsi is available because there are very strong European Union regulations related to addition of sugar to a food product and to sell it, right? But in India, it is growing. So based on our country, the growth and maturity of the product of PepsiCo and Coke is huge. Then eventually a product will decline. So your target is how you can actually prolong the growth and maturity phase. As a product developer, this is your idea. It's more like a microbial growth rate. When you allow the microorganism for fermentation, you actually make sure that you actually try to manipulate the exponential or logarithmic phase where the microorganism grows, because in that phase only microorganism take the substrate and convert the substrate to product, right? So just to exemplify that, this is nothing but a microbial growth curve, the product life cycle. So if you see, this is nothing but the introduction of the product. It's more like a lag phase of microbial growth. And then this is the exponential phase, that is nothing but the growth. And then maturity. Maturity is more like a stationary phase where the product is doing good over the time. And eventually declining or death phase of microorganism, like the product will also decline. Because every product has a life cycle up to what even company plans that this product I'm launching and I'm expecting up to 10 years, 15 years or 5 years. Nowadays, the life cycle has become very short for a new product. Let me tell you this, because there are so many products are coming. And the problem with the consumer is that when you are going to a shopping mall, when you are going to shop anything, say grocery shopping, you have gone, or you have gone to buy a beverage, you have so many options. For a single product category, you have 4, 5, 6 options. So the market has become really competitive. It has become really competitive, and it has become very difficult for a consumer also to choose one over other, because all are leading brands. If you go to spices, you will find JK, you will find Cook Me, you will find Shelly, you will find MDH, you will find Everest, you will find Sunrise, and you cannot ignore one before others. So you have to experience one sample, and then based on your experience, then you can again choose that product, right? So the market is no more a monopoly market for any specific product category. Now it has become completely competitive. So again, if you see the stages, this introduction or R&D part is your responsibility. That is your responsibility as a product developer, as a student of food science, nutrition, food technology. It is your area. This area is your area, and this area is the introduction area. That means very important area. Based on this only, this input only, all those things are going to run: the growth, the maturity, and the declining, right? So let me show you some market trend in new products. So what happened post COVID? Some market trends. These are the market trends. I have just shown few because all is not possible. Amul has launched Tulsi Dood. They have also launched ginger-based dood, whereas tulsi and ginger, these are known as immune-boosting ingredients, right? And these are natural ingredients. So Amul came up with these formulations. Bambino, the first time, Bambino is known for their pasta Asia-wide. But Bambino, the first time we have seen Bambino came up with haldi dood with ashwagandha, right? Some herbal products have come into the market. Then also, Del Monte have developed some immune-boosting mixed fruit beverage variants. We have also seen development of Mother Dairy Haldi Dood over the last 8-9 months. And then Imami and many of the other companies, even nowadays Adani and many of the other oil companies, they came up, edible oil company, they came up with immune-boosting tag, right? Again, need to be validated. I'm not going to tell anything regarding this. Now this is ultimately based on the consumer and how they are liking any specific product. So we should not comment on that, but these are the development which are going on to take the market, you know, to it is nothing but a market catch, what I think personally. And what is the new act that came against the false claim, if at all there are many false claim? So false claim labeling, as per FSSA, there are provisions for penalty. Also, for misleading advertisement, action can be taken under Consumer Forum Act, which got enacted 1986, as this incident is an example of damage of public interest, right? And on 25th July 2020, there has been formation of new act, which will empower the central government to set up a Central Consumer Protection Authority, that is CCPA, that was developed by central government to promote, protect, and enforce the right of consumers. The authority will have the power to impose a penalty on a manufacturer or an endorser. So I will highlight not only manufacturer, but also an endorser. So that means X Bollywood celebrity is endorsing the Y product. And if Y product has a false claim, then as per the CCPA, that endorser is also under the scan. Right, it is a very interesting understanding, and they can and under this act, endorser or manufacturer can be imposed with 10 lakh of a penalty for a false or misleading advertisement. All right, so these are the new ideas which R&Ds are driving now. They are targeting. So this is actually I have cited for you all. So all students, you must develop some ideas, which may not be these ideas, but these are the ideas which are coming up after COVID, and many of the companies have taken it. These are the buzz topics now. So like design and development of phyto protein. Now phyto means the plant-based protein rich, cost-effective, scalable beverage formulations. Then low GI is taking a lot of interest. You must have seen the honey, based on honey, there are a lot of lot of issues happening with FSSAI, and then the companies are also testing it with NMR now. Others would be the company would be telling it better, but low GI has taken low GI. This tag has taken a lot of interest to consumers. So low GI, commercially feasible, ready to cook, because ready to cook, ready to eat, these are the products which came up over the last 6-8 years. If you have seen, and few of the companies like MTR, Venky's, they are doing really good in this ready to eat, ready to cook, or ready to serve based products. Then also identification of antimicrobial, therapeutic or bioactive ingredients from Indian spices, because Indian spices customers have shown lot of confidence on Indian spices and herbs and its selective extraction methodology. Then scope of development of value added indigenous dairy products to boost immunity, as I have already mentioned and I've shown few figure. Then ready to eat protein meal for economically distressed community. So this also we have found that many of the NGOs, they came up, they have developed some product, and also you can also develop ready to eat protein meal for economically distressed. Then development of immune boosting, easy to digest, nutritious, ready to eat or ready to prepare SIF for elderly specific development, because the target consumer would be elderly. And then innovative antimicrobial and biodegradable smart packaging materials for food applications. So also in the packaging material, lot of innovations are coming up. As you know that FSSAI has already notified that in packaging material, this coronavirus may restore for 4 to 6 days, right? So it is for at least 4 days it may stay. So that is why companies have become very active in this regard, and they have accessed lot of sanitation practices. You have to regularly sanitize the packaging material, and now some smart packaging materials are also coming up in the market, be active packaging material or some nano based composite materials are coming up, right? So these are the MOPI identifies. MOPI means Ministry of Food Processing Industry. At the very start, I have told. So these are the MOPI identified focused areas. You can see rural technologies, IoT and artificial intelligence based technologies in farming and food processing, then dairy and food processing, then solar based farm interventions, then agriculture based enterprises, then organic farming and supply chain management. So these are the value addition, what MOPI has focused, from waste to wealth, that is the tagline, and then novel food processing and product technology. These are also some of the area what I have highlighted, which are coming up, already came up in market, very newly developed products. You can also think for those who are passing out and they have some startup idea through incubation cluster, you can also apply. Like whey-based beverages. There are many challenges. It's not very easy because you have to stabilize a product. After developing a product, you have to make sure that the shelf life is good, the product is doing, not having any contaminations. So there are many studies. Even after you develop a product, you have to study, right? So whey-based beverage, then yogurt smoothie, then mushroom, some vitamin D enriched mushroom. These are the new products which are coming up. Then chicken nuggets using pectin, dehydration of grapes. Also I found, because this is something I have taken actually from the ministry side, I have also found mobile app for organic fruits and vegetables, which I found very interesting. And also low cost remote controlled self propelled multifunction boom sprayer. Then you can see that e-commerce store on WhatsApp. This is also I found very interesting. So these are new concept coming up, you have to be innovative. So innovation is the key, I can tell you. Before I end up today, I have a couple of more slides. I just would like to share you that nowadays, madam, do I have another 10 minutes, 5-10 minutes?
I don't have any problem if the students.
Okay, students,
yes,
students are not speaking. So let us discuss any of the students. একটু তোমাদের নাম বলো, তোমাদের সঙ্গে একটু কথা বলি। হ্যালো হ্যালো anyone you can tell like what you think about product, whether you have any product idea, whether you understood the product development, ja bujhte parcho bolo emni, any language, not a problem, language is not a barrier.
স্যার আমরা কিছু প্রোডাক্টের সাথে কিছু প্রোডাক্ট ফ্রি পাই অনেক সময়, তো এই ফ্রি প্রোডাক্ট গুলো কেন দেয় কোম্পানি, মানে এর পেছনে কি কি স্ট্র্যাটেজিস আছে?
হ্যাঁ, এটাও একটা খুব ইন্টারেস্টিং কোয়েশ্চেন। অ্যাকচুয়ালি ফ্রি প্রোডাক্ট গুলো দেওয়া হয় টু মোর ওটাকে ভিজিবিলিটি বাড়ানোর জন্য। দেখবে অনেক সময় অনেক প্রোডাক্ট, দিস ইজ অলসো ওয়ান স্কিম দ্যাট ইজ অ্যাডাপ্টেড, ইউ মাস্ট হ্যাভ সিন দিস, যে একটা প্রোডাক্ট কিনলে, একটা ফুড প্রোডাক্ট কিনলে তার সাথে আর একটা ফুড প্রোডাক্টকে ওর সাথে দিয়ে দেওয়া হয়। ধরো তুমি একটা 5 কেজি অয়েল নিলে, তার সাথে তুমি একটা দেখা গেল একটা স্পাইস ফ্রি পেলে। দেখা যাবে বেশিরভাগ ক্ষেত্রে যেগুলো খুব বেঞ্চমার্ক কোম্পানি, যেগুলো অলরেডি এস্টাবলিশড কোম্পানি, তারা এই ধরনের অফারগুলো এক্সটেন্ড করে না। নতুন কোম্পানি যারা নিউলি ইন্ট্রোডিউসড হচ্ছে মার্কেটে, তারা কি করে, তারা এই ফ্রি প্রোডাক্টগুলোকে দিতে থাকে অ্যাজ পার্ট অফ দেয়ার সেলিং স্ট্র্যাটেজি, প্রোডাক্টটাকে সেল করানোর জন্য। বাট যখন তারা ইন্ট্রোডিউস করছে প্রোডাক্টটাকে, তার আগে তারা কি করছে, ওই ফ্রি প্রোডাক্টগুলো দিয়ে দিয়ে কি করছে, ট্রেন করছে কনজিউমারকে, ট্রেন করানো হচ্ছে যে কনজিউমার তখন ওই প্রোডাক্টগুলো সম্পর্কে জানতে পারছে, ঠিক আছে, এন্ড দেন দে আর কামিং আপ। সো ইটস মোর লাইক, তুমি দেখবে যে হোয়েন জিও সিম হ্যাভ কাম, এভরিবডি হ্যাজ টেকেন জিও, এভরিবডি, সবাই জিও সিম নিয়ে নিল। কেন? বিকজ ইট ওয়াজ ফ্রি দ্যাট টাইম। সো উই ওয়ার ট্রেন্ড to get the free thing first, and then tarpor when we were used to, jokhon amra jio use korte korte used to hoye gelam je free te amra somosto pacchi, then the company imposed the cost to the product, and eventually what happened, amra ki chhere dite parlam, completely chhere dite parlam na product age. So basically it is nothing but a training process of company. Company is actually training the customer regarding the brand, brand ta ke somporke aro aware korar jonno এবং ব্র্যান্ডটাকে প্রমোট করার জন্য এই ধরনের স্কিমকে ইন্ট্রোডিউস করা হচ্ছে।
ওকে স্যার।
সো এনিওয়ান ইউ মে ইন্টারঅ্যাক্ট অলসো, কারণ আমি তো বলছি, তোমাদের একটু শুনলে আমার ভালো লাগবে। সো অল আর ফাইনাল ইয়ার স্টুডেন্টস, সো তোমরা কখন এক্সপিরিয়েন্স করেছো কোনো প্রোডাক্ট ডেভেলপমেন্টের? আচ্ছা, আমি কিন্তু টিচার, তো আমি কিন্তু একটা অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট দেবো। হ্যাঁ, তো এই অ্যাসাইনমেন্টটা তোমাদের করতে হবে। তো আই হ্যাভ ডেভেলপড অ্যান
অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট। একটা কোশ্চেন, হ্যালো স্যার, উড লাইক টু নো অ্যাবাউট এসডব্লিউওটি অ্যানালিসিস এন্ড হাউ ইট ইজ ইট ডান ইন কেস অফ নিউ ফুড প্রোডাক্ট।
একদম ভেরি ইন্টারেস্টিং এন্ড ইম্পর্টেন্ট কোশ্চেন। আই থিংক এই কোশ্চেনটা আমি আসতাম, বাট এটা আমি ইনক্লুড করিনি, কারণ প্রথম লেকচার আমার এটা। তো একটু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং হলে, দু চারজনকে চিনতে পারলে, তাহলে আমি এগুলো ইন্ট্রোডিউস করতাম। এসডব্লিউওটি স্ট্যান্ডস ফর স্ট্রেংথ উইকনেস অপরচুনিটি এন্ড থ্রেট। ইউ ক্যান রাইট ইট, তোমরা লিখতে পারো, এস ফর স্ট্রেংথ, ডাব্লিউ ফর উইকনেস, ও ফর অপরচুনিটি এন্ড টি ফর থ্রেট। তো যে কোনো কোম্পানি যখন কোনো নতুন প্রোডাক্ট নিয়ে আসে মার্কেটে, দেন দে হ্যাভ টু থরলি অ্যানালাইজ অ্যান্ড দে হ্যাভ টু গো ফর আ সোয়াট অ্যানালিসিস, উই কল ইট সোয়াট অ্যানালিসিস। সো হোয়াই দিস সোয়াট অ্যানালিসিস ইজ ডান, এই সোয়াট অ্যানালিসিসটা করা হয় সেই কোম্পানির স্ট্রেংথ, মানে কি স্ট্রেংথ মিন্স সেই কোম্পানির প্রোডাক্ট, দ্য প্রোডাক্ট কোয়ালিটি ইজ ভেরি গুড, দ্য প্রোডাক্ট হ্যাজ আ ভেরি গুড প্যাকেজিং, দ্য প্রোডাক্ট ইজ কামিং উইথ আ লো কস্ট, দিজ আর নাথিং বাট স্ট্রেংথ অফ দ্য কোম্পানি। সো উইকনেস মিন্স হোয়াট, উইকনেস মিন্স মেবি প্রোডাক্টের তো উইকনেস থাকে না, বাট উইকনেস ইন আ টার্ম দ্যাট কম্পিটিটর হয়তো অনেক আগে প্রোডাক্টটাকে লঞ্চ করেছে, এই এই ক্যাটাগরির প্রোডাক্ট। সো প্রোডাক্টকে পেনিট্রেট করতে মার্কেটে অনেক টাইম লাগতে পারে ফ্রম দ্য কোম্পানি, কেন না হয়তো ওই ওই ক্যাটাগরির প্রোডাক্ট অলরেডি এস্টাবলিশড, অলরেডি অনেক বড় বড় কোম্পানি হয়তো এস্টাবলিশ করে দিয়েছে। সো অ্যাজ আ স্টার্ট আপ এই উইকনেসটা, এটাও একটা উইকনেস ফ্রম কোম্পানিজ পয়েন্ট অফ ভিউ, যে যদি একই ক্যাটাগরির প্রোডাক্ট তুমি নাও, তাহলে পেনিট্রেশন উড বি লং টার্ম, পেনিট্রেশন করতে টাইম লাগবে, তোমাকে টাইম দিতে হবে। তুমি ইমিডিয়েটলি প্রোডাক্টকে লঞ্চ করেই একটা বিশাল প্রফিট মার্জিন এক্সপেক্ট করতে পারো না, দেয়ার ক্যান বি লট অফ আদার উইকনেস, রাইট? দেন অপরচুনিটি কি হতে পারে? অপরচুনিটি হতে পারে লাইক দিস কোভিড সিচুয়েশন। নাও দিস কোভিড অলরেডি দিস কোভিড ইজ ডিস্টর্টিং এভরিথিং, দ্য নর্মালসি অফ লাইফ অ্যান্ড এভরিথিং, বাট ফর প্রোডাক্ট ডেভেলপার দিস কোভিড সিচুয়েশন ইজ অ্যান অপরচুনিটি, ইউ ডোন্ট বিলিভ, বিকজ দ্য মার্কেট হ্যাজ চেঞ্জড। কনভেনশনাল মার্কেটের যে কনজাম্পশন হ্যাবিট ছিল সেটা কমপ্লিটলি ডিস্টর্ট হয়ে গেছে। নাও পিপল স্টার্টেড থিঙ্কিং ডিফারেন্টলি, দে আর মোর ডিপেন্ডিং ফর ইন্ডিয়ান পপুলেশন, দে আর মোর ডিপেন্ডিং ইন টু ট্রেডিশনাল ফুড, ট্রেডিশনাল প্রোডাক্টস, রাইট, হার্বাল প্রোডাক্টস। অলসো ইফ ইউ গো টু ওয়েস্টার্ন কান্ট্রি ইউ উইল ফাইন্ড দ্যাট দে আর মোর ইন টু ফাইটো বেসড প্রোডাক্টস, প্ল্যান্ট বেসড প্রোটিন, যেটা আমি বলছিলাম যে প্ল্যান্ট বেসড প্রোডাক্টস, এগুলো অনেক বেশি মার্কেট ক্যাচ হিসেবে উঠে এসছে। সো যেহেতু দের ইজ আ সিগনিফিকেন্ট চেঞ্জ, অর রাদার উই ক্যান টেল সিগনিফিকেন্ট শিফট ইন দ্য মার্কেট, সো প্রোডাক্ট ডেভেলপার জন্য এটা একটা অপরচুনিটি, নতুন নতুন প্রোডাক্ট নিয়ে আসতে পারে। মেনি অফ দ্য স্টার্ট আপ ইন দ্য লাস্ট 8-7 মান্থ, আই নো পার্সোনালি, দে স্টার্টেড দেয়ার স্পাইস বিজনেস, ডিফারেন্ট টাইপ অফ স্পাইস বিজনেস দে স্টার্টেড, রাইট? বিকজ স্পাইস ইজ আ মার্কেট ক্যাচ নাও, রাইট? সো দিস ইজ নাথিং বাট দ্য অপরচুনিটি। And threat is what? Threat is nothing but the competitors. Competitors হচ্ছে তোমার একমাত্র threat. আজকে যদি তুমি একটা baby food category তে নামতে যাও, Nestle হচ্ছে তোমার সব থেকে বড় threat. Because Nestle has taken the 90%, 85-90% of the baby food category. The market is captured by Nestle and maybe 5-10% is shared by Pfizer and Glaxo and other companies. So my point is, threat is your competitor which you cannot change. But you should not have internal threat, like tomar product er quality bhalo na, shelf life kharab, product ta technology advanced noy, ba product ta khub tatari deteriorate korche, market response bhalo na, egulo kintu internal threat, egulo ke tomay recover korte hobe to launch the product in the market. Okay, hopefully I could answer you. Okay, so before we end up today, because I had a separate lecture of shelf life, which I don't think I would be able to finish off, and I would request madam that if madam can arrange another day, then it would be very good. Khub bhalo lageche,
amar bhalo lageche, ami boshe boshe shunchi
ekhane. And before I finish, then I'll just give 3-4 very interesting observations which I have noticed. আর আমি তোমাদের সাথেও শেয়ার করতে চাই স্টুডেন্টদের সাথে, যে এখন যে আমরা সবাই বাড়িতে আছি, এটা কমপ্লিটলি আমরা উই হ্যাভ বিকাম ডিপেন্ডেন্ট টু ডিজিটাল ওয়ার্ল্ড, অ্যান্ড ডিজিটাইজেশন এখন খুব বেশি হয়ে গেছে। ইন্ডিয়াও দেখবে ডিজিটাইজেশন ড্রাইভ নিয়েছে, সবকিছু এখন ডিজিটাইজড। একটা কোভিড ভ্যাকসিনের জন্য যদি বুকিং করতে হয় তাহলেও কোউইন অ্যাপে গিয়ে ডিজিটাইজড ভাবে করতে হয়। সো হাউ দিস ডিজিটাইজড প্ল্যাটফর্ম হ্যাজ ইনফ্লুয়েন্সড দ্য প্রোডাক্ট, ফুড প্রোডাক্ট। তো এটা আমি 3-4 স্লাইড রেখেছি, জাস্ট তোমরা একটু দেখো, কিছু ইনফরমেশন হ্যাভ কালেক্টেড। ওয়ান অফ দ্য ইন্ডাস্ট্রি চ্যালেঞ্জেস ইজ নাও দ্য নিউ এজ অফ ট্রান্সপেরেন্সি অ্যান্ড অথেন্টিসিটি, লাইক দ্য মোর অনেস্ট দ্য প্রোডাক্ট দ্য মোর সাকসেসফুল দ্য ব্র্যান্ড। নাও দিস ইজ দ্য গ্লোবাল ট্রেন্ড, রাইট? নাও গ্লোবালি ইফ ইউ সি, গ্লোবালি পিপল আর নট থিঙ্কিং অ্যাবাউট দ্য ব্র্যান্ড নাও। 70% অফ দ্য কনজিউমার্স আর মোস্ট ইন্টারেস্টেড ইন ট্রান্সপেরেন্সি অ্যাবাউট প্রোডাক্ট rather than the companies who are making it. So eta Nestle toiri kore na ITC toiri kore does not make difference. If I'm testing a product and it is made by a startup, still it's okay, but it should taste good. So new population jara amra bolbo jara new generation er jonno kintu jemon middle aged ba old generation, they are still brand conscious. New generation er jonno kintu ekta amra observation dekhte pacchi je 70% of the consumer from the new generation, they are not considering brand, they are considering the product, the honesty of the product, the transparency of the product. So ei product er somosto kichu dekhte pacche kina, supply chain ta transparent kina, ekhon sob kichu available kintu internet e. And 55% of the consumer demand more information on social health, environment and safety issues. Eta aro important jayga je ekhon kintu consumer sob kichu jante chay, they want to know everything, they want to know the the social, the environmental, the safety aspect, and 86% of business leaders think they are already doing enough. That is also another interesting observation, right? Then another challenge is sustainability, jeta ami bollam, in the eyes of consumer, in terms of supply chain, in terms of quality of raw material, in terms of end of life, mane product life cycle. And last but not the least, eta ektu complex byapar, eventually tumra bujhte parbe that আগে আমরা যেটা বিজনেসের ক্ষেত্রে ফলো করা হতো লিনিয়ার সাপ্লাই চেন, এখন লিনিয়ার সাপ্লাই চেন মডেলটা আর নেই, এখন একটা নন লিনিয়ার কনসেপ্ট চলে এসেছে, হ্যাঁ, হুইচ ইজ রিয়েলি ডাইনামিক, মানে এখন অনেক ডাইনামিক চেঞ্জেস হচ্ছে পোস্ট কোভিড, সাপ্লাই চেনটা এখন খুব স্মুথ নয়, সাপ্লাই চেনটা যেহেতু অনেক ডিস্টরশন হয়েছে, এখন সাপ্লাই চেনটা অনেক নন লিনিয়ার একটা বিহেভিয়ার শো করছে, ঠিক আছে, এবং তার জন্য ইন্টারনাল এবং এক্সটার্নাল যে প্যারামিটার্স গুলো সেগুলো কিন্তু খুব ইম্পর্টেন্ট। এক্সটার্নাল প্যারামিটার্স মানে কি, না এক্সপোনেনশিয়াল ইনক্রিজ অফ স্টেক হোল্ডার্স এক্সপেকটেশন, মানে কনজিউমার স্টেক হোল্ডার তাদের এক্সপেকটেশন অনেক বেড়ে গেছে, এক্সপোনেনশিয়ালি বেড়েছে, ডিজিটাল সার্ভিসেস অ্যান্ড কনজিউমার এক্সপিরিয়েন্স, দেন ফ্রম প্রোডাক্ট ফিচার্স টু স্টোরি টেলিং, এখন দেখবে প্রোডাক্টের থেকেও একটা স্টোরি বলা হচ্ছে, প্রোডাক্টকে নিয়ে একটা স্টোরি ডেভেলপ করা হচ্ছে, তোমরা অ্যাডভার্টাইজমেন্টেও দেখতে পাবে যে যখন একটা প্রোডাক্টকে এস্টাবলিশ করা হয় তখন একটা স্টোরির মাধ্যমে এস্টাবলিশ করা হয়, ঠিক আছে, দেন ডিজিটাইজেশন ইজ ইনক্রিজিং কনজিউমার পাওয়ার, আর ইন্টারনালের মধ্যে কি কি আছে, ফাস্টার রেপুটেশন রিস্ক, কারণ একটা প্রোডাক্ট আসার পরেই সেটা হয়তো মার্কেট থেকে অ্যাবলিশ হয়ে যাচ্ছে ডিউ টু ইটস ইমপ্রপার কোয়ালিটি পেনিট্রেশন পলিসি, তারপর শর্টার প্রোডাক্ট লাইফ সাইকেল, দেন ইভলভিং রেগুলেশনস অ্যান্ড ইনক্রিজড এফিসিয়েন্সি প্রেশার, এটা কিন্তু মারাত্মক চলে এসেছে, কারণ একটা প্রোডাক্টকে লঞ্চ করিয়েই সেটাকে কোনোভাবে হিট করাতে হবে, ইফ ইউ ক্যানট হিট তোমরা কিন্তু সেকেন্ড টাইম চান্স পাবে না, থার্ড টাইম চান্স পাবে না, দিস ইজ বিকামিং ভেরি ডিফিকাল্ট। আগে অনেক প্রোডাক্ট ডেভেলপ হয়েছে, অনেক কোম্পানি তারা ফেল হয়েছে, আবার ডেভেলপ করেছে, ফেল হয়েছে, এখন কিন্তু ইনভেস্টার্স দে আর ভেরি স্মার্ট, যদি কোনো প্রাইভেট ইনভেস্টার তোমাকে ইনভেস্ট করে তোমার প্রোডাক্ট আইডিয়াকে, দেন ইউ হ্যাভ টু মেক শিওর দ্যাট ইউ হ্যাভ টু গিভ কনফিডেন্স টু দ্য প্রাইভেট ইনভেস্টার, সেই ইনভেস্টর কিন্তু শুনবে না তোমার প্রোডাক্ট যদি ফেল হয়, তো তোমাকে কিন্তু প্রাইমারি অ্যানালিসিস করে নিতে হবে। সো দেয়ার ইজ আ ট্রাস্ট গ্যাপ যেটা ছিল, যে ট্রাস্ট গ্যাপটা ইজ অলওয়েজ দেয়ার, সেই ট্রাস্ট গ্যাপটাকে কিভাবে নালিফাই করা যায় সেটাই কিন্তু এখন আমাদের নিউ জেনারেশনের জন্য চ্যালেঞ্জ। অ্যান্ড অ্যাজ আ কনজিউমার উড ইউ ওয়েলকাম মোর ইনফরমেশন অ্যাবাউট দ্য ফলোয়িং থিং, এটা আমি একটা সার্ভে করেছিলাম, আইল জাস্ট শো ইউ হোয়াট আর দ্য ইনফরমেশন অ্যাজ আ কনজিউমার ইউ নিড, ফুড সেফটি, হেলথ ইস্যু, এনভায়রনমেন্টাল ইস্যু, অল অফ দ্য অ্যাবাভ, নান অফ দ্য অ্যাবাভ, ইন্টারেস্টিংলি ফাউন্ড দ্যাট 91% অফ দ্য কনজিউমার দে হ্যাভ ভোটেড ফর অল অফ দ্য অ্যাবাভ, দ্যাট মিনস কনজিউমার কিন্তু এখন সব কিছুই জানতে চায়, এনভায়রনমেন্টাল প্যারামিটারও জানতে চায়, একটা প্রোডাক্টের কার্বন ফুটপ্রিন্ট নিয়ে জানতে চায়, সাস্টেনেবিলিটি নিয়েও জানতে চায়, সো ইট ইজ নো মোর ইন টু কোর কোয়ালিটি অ্যাসপেক্ট, বিয়ন্ড কোয়ালিটি কিন্তু আরো বেশ কয়েকটা জায়গা এখন ডেভেলপ করেছে। ব্লকচেন টেকনোলজি চলে এসছে, এটা নিয়েও আমি একটা সার্ভে করেছিলাম যে ব্লকচেন টেকনোলজি, হোয়েদার ডু ইউ থিঙ্ক ব্লকচেন টেকনোলজি ইজ সিকিউরড, ইটস আ সিকিউরড টেকনোলজি, এন্ড আই ফাউন্ড আ ভেরি,
স্যার ব্লকচেন টেকনোলজিটা কি?
ব্লকচেন টেকনোলজি ইজ আ টেকনোলজি হুইচ ইজ বেসড অন ওয়েল এস্টাবলিশড ক্রিপ্টোগ্রাফিক প্রিন্সিপালস, বেসিক্যালি এই যে আমরা প্রোডাক্ট, বিভিন্ন প্রোডাক্টকে আমি আসছি পরের স্লাইডটায়, সেটা দিয়ে আমি এন্ড আপ করবো, it's a technology based on well established cryptographic principles and operations as a distributed and secure repository providing a way of for information to be recorded and shared through a peer to peer community, eto kichu bojha dorkar nei, jeta bujhte hobe seta hocche ekta product from farming to amra boli farm to fork, tai to ei je farm theke fork মানে একদম রেস্টুরেন্টের টেবিলে তুমি পাচ্ছ আর ফার্মে সেটাকে কালটিভেট করা হচ্ছে, এর মধ্যে তো প্রচুর প্রসেসেস যাচ্ছে, তাই না, ডিস্ট্রিবিউশন, তার ট্রান্সপোর্ট, তার প্রিপারেশন, তার প্রসেসিং, তার প্যাকেজিং, সব কিছু, তো এই যে ফার্ম থেকে স্টোরে তুমি প্রোডাক্টটা পাচ্ছ তার মধ্যে প্রচুর ডেটা ইনভলভ আছে, এবং এই ডেটাগুলোকে কত সিকিউরড ভাবে ডেটাগুলোকে হ্যান্ডেল করা যেতে পারে, তো বেসিক্যালি তুমি বলতে পারো ডেটা অ্যানালিটিক্সটাকে আরো ইমপ্রুভড লেভেলে নিয়ে যাওয়ার জন্য রিলেটেড টু আ প্রোডাক্ট এই ব্লকচেন টেকনোলজিটা, যেটাকে আমরা বলি বেসড অন ক্রিপ্টোগ্রাফিক প্রিন্সিপাল, আমরা ব্লকচেন মানে আমাদের একটা খুব অদ্ভুত ধারণা আছে, ব্লকচেন মানে বোধহয় ওই ক্রিপ্টোকারেন্সি বা এই ধরনের কিছু ইনভেস্টমেন্ট, এরকম নয়। ব্লকচেনকে এখন ইউজ করা হচ্ছে, ব্লকচেন ইজ আ ভেরি সিকিউর টেকনোলজি, এটাকে ইউজ করা হচ্ছে তোমার ফ্রম ফার্ম টু ফর্ক ফর ডেটা রিলায়াবিলিটি, ডেটাকে রিট্রেস করার জন্য, ডেটাকে ইউনো ডেটাকে ট্রেসেবল করার জন্য। তো ডেটা যাতে ট্রেসেবিলিটি থাকে, সেই ট্রেসেবিলিটির জন্য কিন্তু বিভিন্ন কোম্পানি স্টার্টেড ইউজিং দিস ব্লকচেন টেকনোলজি। মানে এটা খুব অ্যাডভান্সড একটা টেকনোলজি, যেটা কিনা পার্সিয়ালি আর্টিফিশিয়াল ইন্টেলিজেন্স, হ্যাঁ, সিমুলেশনস, অনেক ধরনের সফটওয়্যার অ্যাপ্লিকেশনস কেউ ইউজ করছে। এবং আমি তোমায় দেখাবো একটা, জাস্ট ফর অ্যান এক্সাম্পল, সেই গ্রেপ থেকে ওয়াইন তৈরি করা হয়, তাই তো? তো গ্রেপ থেকে যে ওয়াইন তৈরি করা হয়, গ্রেপ হচ্ছে এগ্রিকালচারাল প্রোডিউস, যেটাকে ভিনিফিকেশন করা হয়, ফার্মেন্টেশন করি আমরা, অ্যান্ড দেন ভিনিফিকেশনের পরে বটলিং করা হয়, ডিস্ট্রিবিউশন করা হয়, দেন ডিস্ট্রিবিউশন থেকে পয়েন্ট অফ সেলে যায়, তারপর এটা কনজিউমারের কাছে যায়, তাই তো? তো এবার যদি এটাকে দেখি, ব্লকচেন এটাকে কি করে ট্র্যাক করে, এই এগ্রিকালচারাল অ্যাক্টিভিটিটাকে রেকর্ড করা হয়, রেকর্ডিং অফ ফিল্ড অ্যাক্টিভিটি, ঠিক আছে? দেন ভিনিফিকেশনে রেকর্ডিং অফ কোয়ালিটি, কোয়ালিটিটাকেও মনিটরিং করা হচ্ছে কিন্তু ব্লকচেনের থ্রু দিয়ে। দেন বটলিং করা হচ্ছে বেসড অন এনভায়রনমেন্টাল অ্যান্ড সোশ্যাল ডেটা, সেটাকেও ইনসিওর করা হচ্ছে থ্রু ব্লকচেন। দেন ডিস্ট্রিবিউশন করা হচ্ছে বেসড অন রেকর্ডিং অফ চেইন অফ কাস্টডি, রাইট? সো ইন ডিফারেন্ট সেগমেন্ট, ডিফারেন্ট পয়েন্ট, যে প্রসেসেস গুলো আছে, সেই প্রসেসেসে যে হিউজ ডেটা জেনারেট হচ্ছে, সেই ডেটাগুলোকে ট্রেসেবল করার জন্য আমরা এই ধরনের ব্লকচেন টেকনোলজি ইউজ করছি, ইন অর্ডার টু বেটার ম্যানেজ দ্য ডেটা, হোয়াট উই কল ডেটা ম্যানেজমেন্ট, রাইট? অ্যান্ড এটার অ্যাপ্লিকেশন কোথায় দেখতে পাই আমরা? কোন রিটেল স্টোরে যাবে তুমি দেখতে পারে, নট ফর রিটেল স্টোর, এমনি প্রোডাক্টের মধ্যেও এখন চলে এসছে কিউআর কোড, হ্যাঁ, বার কোড থাকে, কিউআর কোড থাকে, দেন এনএফসি থাকে, দ্যাট ইজ নিয়ার ফিল্ড কমিউনিকেশনস, অ্যান্ড আরএফআইডি, দ্যাট ইজ রেডিও ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি আইডেন্টিফিকেশনস, এইগুলো কিন্তু ইউজ করা হচ্ছে এখন, তুমি দেখতে পাবে। অ্যান্ড এইগুলো সব এনক্রিপ্টেড, লাইক হোয়াটসঅ্যাপেও থাকে কল টু কল এনক্রিপ্টেড, লাইক দিজ আর অল কামিং উইথ এনক্রিপ্টেড, দ্যাট মিনস ইট ইজ হাইলি সিকিউরড, ঠিক আছে? তো সিকিউরিটি ইজ ইম্পর্টেন্ট, অ্যান্ড আনটিল ইউ আর নট অ্যাওয়ার, তোমারও একটা ভয় থাকবে ব্লকচেনটা কি একটা জিনিস। So, but it is coming with a lot of technology and validation of that technology is done by big software houses. ঠিক আছে? তো এখন আর্টিফিশিয়াল ইন্টেলিজেন্স, ব্লকচেন, এগুলো কিন্তু প্রচন্ডভাবে আইওটি বেসড থিং, এগুলো কিন্তু চলে আসছে এখন প্রোডাক্ট ডেভেলপমেন্টের ক্ষেত্রে। এখন ডিজিটাল যত বেশি বাড়বে, আরো এই ধরনের ডিজিটাল প্ল্যাটফর্ম দেখবে ইন কামিং ফিউ ইয়ার্স, এইগুলো কিন্তু আরো বেশি করে আসবে আমাদের। সো বিফোর আই ফিনিশ অফ, আই হ্যাভ আ ভেরি স্মল, I'll just share a very small assignment. এই অ্যাসাইনমেন্টটা তোমরা সলভ করো, এটা একটা টেকনিক্যাল, একটা একটা ছোট্ট ম্যাথামেটিক্স, এটা তোমরা সলভ করো, অ্যান্ড এরপর যদি আমি কোনো ক্লাস পাই, ম্যাডাম যদি একটা ক্লাস অ্যারেঞ্জ করেন, তাহলে ডেফিনেটলি আমি চেষ্টা করব যে সেখানে শেলফ লাইফ বা রেগুলেটরির কিছু কিছু জায়গা আমি ডিসকাস করার চেষ্টা করব। So just I have to close it. Just give me 1 minute. Is it coming now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So এটা একটা ছোট্ট ম্যাথামেটিক্স, খুব ইন্টারেস্টিং, কারণ তোমাদের হয়তো পরে অনেক কোম্পানিতে জয়েন করেও করতে হতে পারে এই ধরনের প্রবলেম সলভ। সো দ্য শেলফ লাইফ অফ আ ফুড প্রোডাক্ট অ্যাট আ স্টোরেজ টেম্পারেচার অফ 15°C, 15°C টেম্পারেচারে দ্য শেলফ লাইফ ইজ 5 days। দ্য প্রোডাক্টটাকে যদি তুমি 15°C স্টোর করো, তাহলে 5 days তার শেলফ লাইফ থাকবে। হোয়াট উইল বি দ্য শেলফ লাইফ অ্যাট আ স্টোরেজ টেম্পারেচার অফ 3°, মানে ওই প্রোডাক্টারই শেলফ লাইফ, যদি তুমি প্রোডাক্টের টেম্পারেচারটাকে কমিয়ে 15°C থেকে 3°C নিয়ে আসো, তাহলে ওই প্রোডাক্টের শেলফ লাইফ কতদিন হবে। এখানে কিছু ভ্যালু দিয়ে দিয়েছে, Q10 বলে একটা ফ্যাক্টর আছে, যেটা ইজ নাথিং বাট আ মেজার অফ ফোল্ড অফ, 2-3 fold অফ ইনক্রিমেন্ট হয় রিয়াকশনের উইথ এভরি 10° ইনক্রিজ ইন টেম্পারেচার, যেটা তোমরা হয়তো পড়েওছো বায়োকেমিস্ট্রিতে। সো ইনক্রিমেন্ট ইন টেম্পারেচার with every 10°C increment in temperature, the rate of any chemical or biochemical reaction increases by 2-3 fold. So, 2-3 degree...
temperature coefficient?
Yeah, Yes, Q10 is nothing but the temperature coefficient, and it is nothing but the increment of any reaction by 2 to 3 fold with increment of 10 degree C of its reaction. So, jodi tumi ekta reaction ke 27 degree C theke 37 degree C te niye jao, like enzyme er jonno hoy, any of the biochemical product er jonno hoy, food product er jonno hoy, chemical product er jonno hoy. So, increase korle temperature, kinetics, as per kinetics, rate of reaction bare. So, dekha jay generally rate 2 to 3 fold bare, that is nothing but the Q10 or temperature coefficient. Keno temperature coefficient er kotha bolechi, karon ekhane temperature komano baranor kotha bola hoyeche 15 degree C theke 3 degree C te niye asha hoyeche. Thik ache? So, temperature coefficient er sathe shelf life er ki relation ache, seta khuje bar korar chesta koro. তাহলে দেখবে ম্যাথটা খুব ইজি. অ্যান্ড জেড একটা দেওয়া আছে, জেড ইজ নাথিং বাট দ্য টাইম, যে টাইমে জেনারেলি আমরা শেলফ লাইফ মানে কি আমরা প্রোডাক্টের কোয়ালিটিকে এনহ্যান্স, কোয়ালিটিকে সেম কোয়ালিটি রাখি উইথ এনহ্যান্স টাইম, তাই তো? সো ইউ আর অ্যাকচুয়ালি ট্রাইং টু মেনটেন দ্য কিপিং কোয়ালিটি অফ আ ফুড প্রোডাক্ট বাই এনশিওরিং দ্যাট দ্য প্রোডাক্ট ইজ সেফ. সো জেড ইজ দ্য রেফারেন্স টেম্পারেচার is given as 20 degree C. So reference temperature ও definitely ওই equation এ আসবে. একটা ছোট্ট equation যেটা আমি এখন বলছি না, তো ওই equationটা দিয়ে এই product, এই problemটা তুমি solve করতে পারবে. So it's a single assignment and I had a presentation today with shelf life which I'm not going to cover because I think it's about 2 hours
going on. সেইটা আরেকদিন আমি বন্দোবস্ত করব.
Madam will definitely
thank
arrange
you
one day. Thank you. Thank you, Pubali ma'am.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank
you so much.
Wonderful opportunity given by madam. And I'm so privileged. Tomare shobar sathe interact korte pere ebong any of the issues if you have, তুমি definitely madam কে জানাও, madam এর through দিয়ে definitely you can contact me.
Not an issue. তুমি কোনো প্রশ্ন থাকে বলতেই পারছো. যে ওর ফুড প্রোডাক্টে একেবারে প্রচন্ড মানে একটা কবজা দক্ষতার জায়গা, তো সেইখানে যদি কিছু প্রশ্ন টশ্ন থাকে
তো তোমাদের কারণে কোনো প্রশ্ন থাকে ডেফিনেটলি তোমরা করতে
আমি পাঠিয়ে দিই.
So thank you ma'am, again, thank you for this opportunity and thank you everyone for your patient hearing. Thank you
sir.
Thank you.